Hey YouTubers, it's Heretic. Are you here with a quick little video here about a very serious gaming subject, a subject that I think hasn't been really discussed. So I'm going to talk a little bit about the social aspect of gaming. So one of the unique things about tabletop gaming is that, well, it's basically a social game. We have to have our opponent physically in front of us when we play. And that's fine when you're, you know, battling against your buddies or whatever. But what happens when you run into someone who you might not care for or get along with as a person and you meet for the first time? So we're going to talk about this little slop holler guy here. He's going to represent our new guy, and he just bought his box set, and he put his models together, and he assembled them for the first time, and then he runs into this guy, who's the experienced competitive gamer, and they're about to clash. And in all honesty, the war pig is going to destroy the little slop, the egg hauler guy. And the one thing I would say is both players could actually come away with a positive experience if they were just honest about who they were to the other person. So for the experienced wargamer, let's say he is working on his meta. He wants to play as many games as possible because he's gearing up for a tournament, or maybe he just likes to win at all costs. Normally that would be looked down upon, but I'm actually on the other side of this. I actually think he would, if he was, you know, there's nothing wrong with power gaming as long as you're not cheating. So if you're within the rules and you just happen to be a competitive gamer, that's who you are. And if the war pig said, hey, slop holler, all right, I realize that you're new at the game, and if you play me, I'm just going to beat you to the ground, and you might possibly quit the game. Well, then the slop holler here would have a choice. He would say, yeah, I think I'll play somebody else, or, hey, you know what, I want to learn, and I want to learn and beat the best. And so, you know, I just wish that gamers were just more honest about each other. And so I put this little parody video. Don't take it too seriously, but this is what I think what it would look like if people were more honest about what type of gamer they're all about. Okay, before you write any hate comments, I have nothing against the guy who made that original video. I believe it was a response video to WG Consortium. I just thought it would be funny if, you know, a power gamer had was honest, you know, I'm not saying you're a power gamer, whoever you are. I'm just saying if a power gamer were to make the same video and just, you know, be honest about what his goals are when he games. Getting back on topic, I hear a lot of negative stigma about people who power game or metagame, whatever you want to call it, right? This might be a war chicken, but it's actually a war pig in the game. So, you know, you can call it whatever you want. I don't know if that analogy made any sense to anybody, but if you played Malahoe, maybe you would understand that these are effectively the same model. So whatever you want to call your style of gaming, just, you know, that's what you like to be. And I don't see anything wrong with that, unless you're cheating. Like, for example, if the war pig made a mistake and exposed, say, his land raider to the bunny's, you know, devastator squad that's going to blow it out of the water, and he says, oh, no, I pop smoke, even though he knows that he shot with that land raider, there's no way he could have popped smoke, but he also knows that the bunny doesn't know the rules well enough, then that's the only true line that you can cross. When you want to win to the point that, you know, you will cheat to get it. But if your list is just a really tough list and it's hard to beat, more power to you. I think just be honest about who you are. And as far as maybe forcing this guy to quit because he's had so many bad experiences, if he knew what he was getting into, you know, he would play perhaps some other, you know, players that are a little bit less serious than this rampaging, stampeding war pig. So that's my tactic. That's kind of how I deal with the awkwardness of playing somebody who is viewed by most people as, you know, not a fun game to have. I just try to have fun no matter what. I mean, I am playing with little guys in bunny suits. And so how can you not have fun? Even if I get beat, I try to do something in the game. So, you know, I can take away something. And it becomes a personal responsibility on both gamers. They need to say, well, my goal is to learn the game. And maybe you're too advanced for me and you don't want to take it easy on me. Then I'll, you know, take my models and play someone else. And for the war pig, you know, if he's just looking to get experience, playing a bunch of different stuff, and, you know, he's trying to build his most competitive list, then I really don't see anything wrong with it, as long as you don't cheat. So that's my little message of the day. You can disagree with me if you want, but that's how I feel. All right, man, I'll see you guys in the next vid. Just go sleep. Turn the water, shade of faith.